In this video, I'm going to show you how to calculate measures of central tendency and variability using SPSS. It's a fairly simple process. You just need to go to Analyze, and then Descriptive Statistics, and over to Frequencies. Excuse me. From here, you just need to pick whichever variable you would like to look at. I'll go with, I don't know, age of respondent. So I'll click on that and I click the arrow to move it over into this variables box. And from here, I can tell SPSS which measures of variability to calculate. So you click on statistics, you can have it break it up into quartiles if you like. If you want the mean and the median, you could even do the mode in terms of measures of central tendency. SPSS uses the word dispersion rather than variability, but they mean the same thing and they have the same options. So we can get the standard deviation, the variance, and the range. Now it's important when you're choosing the measures of variability and central tendency that you would like, that you only choose those that are appropriate for the level of measurement that you're dealing with. So if you have a nominal level variable, I wouldn't recommend having it calculate the mean and the median for you. It totally will, just because that's how SPSS is, but it doesn't really make any sense. So once you've selected all of the measures of central tendency and variability that you wanted to look at, you can just click continue. Now you have the option of having it either display frequency tables or not. When I'm doing an interval ratio level variable, I usually tell it to not display frequency tables. I uncheck that box just because frequency tables for interval ratio level variables tend to be very large. If it's a nominal level variable, it should be a lot smaller. So I'm just going to click OK. And my output window will pop up. And these are my measures of central tendency and variability. You can see it tells me the number of people who are in my sample, gives me the mean age of everyone, the median age. It looks like the mean is a little bit higher than the median, which suggests a slight positive skew. The mode is 30, gives me standard deviation and variance. It also gives me a range, the difference between the oldest respondent and the youngest respondent. And then because I asked it to break it up into quartiles, we also have, we could calculate the interquartile range as well by subtracting 29 from 43, give us the interquartile range. So I'll do another one just to show you what it might look like with a nominal level variable, for example. So again, you're going to go to Analyze, and then Descriptive Statistics, and Frequencies. Let's get rid of Age, and this time let's do, Current Marital Status. Click on Statistics. Now we can no longer do quartiles because this is a nominal level variable. We can't do the mean, so we'll have to uncheck that. Median, same thing. We'll have to get rid of all of these as well. There actually is one measure of variability that you can use with nominal level data. It's known as the Index of Qualitative Variation, and no one ever really uses it, so that's why it's not part of SPSS, and that's why your instructor most likely will not lecture on it. So really all we have as far as nominal level data are concerned is the mode to work with. So again, I'll just click continue and then click OK. And it looks like the mode is 1. Now it's like, okay, well, what does 1 mean? So to figure that out, we're going to have to go back to our variable view. Go to our marital status. It looks like 1 is married. So the mode for our sample would be married. All right, one more thing. Sometimes it's useful to make a box plot when you're dealing with measures of variability. So to do that, you'll go to Graphs, and then you'll go to Legacy Dialogues, and then down to Box Plot. Now when we were doing graphs in our previous chapter, we were doing only summaries for groups of cases. In this case, however, it's a little bit more useful to do summaries of separate variables. It will summarize all the information in a single variable. It gives you a pretty good visual representation. So I'll click that instead of summaries of groups of cases. Then I'm going to click Define. Again, you can see I've been playing with this previously. So let's do a box plot for the respondent's age. Now, if we wanted to break that up according to, say, visa category or race, we could put our label that variable in this label cases by box. But this time, let's just make one. So I'll click OK. And this will give me my nice box plot for age. Now you can see here there are some outliers plotted here at the top. These numbers, this like 1,948 and 3,327, it's not saying that those people claim to be almost 2,000 or over 3,000 years old. These are actually the numbers of the respondents. So it looks like respondent number 1,948 is pushing, I don't know, 83, 85. And so they're plotted all by themselves. They're sort of outside the norm as far as the age of respondents are concerned.